Well, I think one of the things that I'm happy to do, as Lizzie said, I was on the plan for that. And one of the things I think that was prominent about this exhibition for me was just the sort of iterating that synchronicity was a component of how tracking blood, you know, kind of our relationship with water is existent. And the reason I say that is that I sort of happened in to the gallery and Lizzie was putting together this exhibition about Deluge of blood and, you know, tragedy. And I said, well, I'm actually an artist who makes paintings of, you know, aftermath, different catastrophes that, you know, already occurred. Just to be quick about how I come to that, it's I grew up in Biloxi, Mississippi, and at some point in time, in 1969, in fact, Biloxi was the site of one of the largest and most devastating hurricanes to hit the North American coast, and its devastation was so great that there were lots of images and lots of media attention surrounding that event. The local event that was important for me is that because I was living in Biloxi, I was a small child at the time, I actually lived through the hurricane, and I was in an attic with my family as a water burglar, so it was quite a traumatic event. Mm-hmm. And as an event that had occurred in my history, it signaled actually the loss of our home, the loss of our community, the loss of basically all the things that were consistent with, you know, how we live in our communities, in our homes. So I think just as a foundational text for me, that was pretty big. And as an artist, in terms of, you know, how I make my work. My work is contingent on images, and I'm very fascinated with the way images sort of repopulate our memory, our consciousness, everything that connects our consciousness. And so these are things that are often sort of related about my work when I'm making work. Having said that, there's a photographic edge to the way I work because it's the quality of the image that we most recognize as the real. Which is also, of course, a bit ironic because everything is still understood that nothing is real, or there's lots of, you know, ways we can dissect that abstractly. My work always deals with the way images are disseminated, the way we find them, how we come to know them. And in relation to my past work, this meant that around the public records and full images that were known to me, or maybe unknown to me, but known to real, actual experimental context, and just sort of looking at those intersections of, you know, the real, memory, or photographic images. A lot of those things have to do with the past and the way we live in our environments. Part of what happens with looking at images that are part of public records, for instance, with the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina, for instance, part of that has to do with the fact that there being recorded for purpose, my purpose is for the record of economic destruction. So again, tangential to my work is this understanding of how are we living in the landscape, you know, what are the psychological connections that we have to the landscape, and how are we in fact shaping what it is we're doing, which is where Ben sort of noted, you know, my interest in things that were more consistent with my contemporary living, which is, you know, I live in Atlanta, Georgia, and our infrastructure is falling apart, and you know, basically, I'm never going to be part of a sinkhole at any time. And what happens is that you begin to sort of understand that, you know, that there, you know, that all of this is being made. You know, like the trees that are growing in the neighborhoods that I'm in, we're all put there. And so while they might be native, they may or may not be natural, or they might be naturalized. And so these kinds of terms that then become a little more understood once we become aware of the things that are in our neighborhoods. Now, related specifically to this event, I have been wanting to do a piece that was consistent with the nature of, you know, how things are changeable and movable. I wanted to do a site-specific painting that kind of flies in the face of, you know, what people consider painting to be, which is a permanent thing, right? It's painting. It's valuable. It's, you know, it's going to be around forever. So this notion of coming in and actually making paint, that was meant to not be permanent. It was really something I wanted to do. Additionally, I wanted to deal with imagery that perhaps people that were in the community touched by that in ways that, like, if your house didn't get flooded, it didn't matter. Like, it didn't matter if you set a lot of rain or what. And meanwhile, there were people who were, you know, devastated. All their, you know, photographs were lost. You know, everything was destroyed. Kind of terrible things that were occurring. So, just to kind of know this work, to be conscious of that, that's part of my desire. The other part of it was to not at all consider that I'm trying to make any kind of statement about a communal loss or memorializing events of trauma or, you know, disaster. But just acknowledging that, you know, that, you know, I'm present and I'm seeing these images. So I take lots of these images from the websites and just write their news stations, how to re-photograph them so that I would have a very clear sort of relationship to the lens. You know, the pieces that I've worked on here were marked by a medium that sort of gave an image of what happened